I'm going to do a quick tutorial on pruning your tomato plants. I have Roma's and Amish paste planted. So what I like to do is to remove all the suckers. So right here is what is called a sucker. It grows in between each piece, and what you want to do is just pinch that off. And you want to make sure you do that on all of them. This is going to help all the nutrients go to where it needs to. And then your plant doesn't get overgrown and it's manageable. Now, you never want to take off the terminal bud. That's where you're going to get your height from. Now, at the end of the season, you can take this off. That's going to help you get the last growth out of all your tomatoes before the frost comes, and you're not going to get any more height. But I leave that until the very end of the season. Now, I staked all my tomatoes this year due to I didn't have a lot of space. I don't have a lot of raised beds built, and I didn't have a rototiller, and now I do. So this year I kind of just finagled everything together and staked them instead of putting them in cages, and I planted them too close together, which I know, but options were slim this year. So what else I do is I like to make sure that no leaves or anything are touching the ground. Like this one over here is getting low, and I just pinch this off. And it doesn't matter because they're the lower branches of the tomato. I want to try and keep away blight. We had a hard rain last night, so my tomatoes are wet and they haven't dried off yet. But I want to make sure that my tomatoes aren't really touching. That's going to keep away disease and help with everything. So I just kind of take that leaf off and just make sure my tomatoes aren't touching. They are starting to blossom out, so in about a month I should have beautiful tomatoes. I use Amish paste and Roma's. It gives me a less juicy tomato. They're both really meaty tomatoes, and where I use mine mostly just for spaghetti sauce and salsa, gives me a great option that I don't have to take more time when I'm reducing the sauce. Now, over here, I did find a very large sucker that I forgot to pinch off. I try and get them quickly so that I'm not taking such a large branch off. I try and keep everything nice and clean so it heals up quickly. This is a little bit bigger, and I will pinch it off. I try and keep it done quickly just so that there's less chance of disease entering my plants. Thanks for tuning in to my pruning video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to put them down below. Hit like as always. Subscribe if you want to stay tuned to my channel. I'll be adding new videos each week. Have a great day from Bunker Hill Homestead.